Hello everyone, welcome back to another online edition of SFCAC Sunday School. I'm so happy that you could join us today. We will learn God's Word and have a simple activity that you could do together with your family. There will be one lesson for everyone. It is a blessing that we can still worship together in this time, growing in our faith and learning what God is teaching us, like how we can love Him and love each other. Let us start in a word of prayer. Dear God, we thank you for being our God. We praise you today because Jesus is alive. As we listen with joyful and thankful hearts, let us learn more about you. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today, we're going to learn how Jesus conquered death. At the end of our lesson last week, we learned Joseph of Arimathea placed Jesus' body in a tomb. A large stone was rolled in front of the opening so no one could get in or out. Pilate was afraid someone would try to steal Jesus' body, so he ordered soldiers to guard the tomb. But none of that kept Jesus coming back to life. After Jesus had been dead for 3 days, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to the tomb where Jesus' body has been placed. When they arrived at the tomb, the stone was rolled away and the tomb was empty. They were very upset, but an angel of the Lord appeared. The angel told the woman to come see the place where Jesus had been and then tell his disciples that he was alive. Mary Magdalene ran to tell Peter and John. They followed her and saw the empty tomb too. After they left, Mary Magdalene was crying at the tomb. Jesus appeared to her and told her to go tell the others the good news. She was an eyewitness of the risen Savior. An eyewitness is someone who sees something happen and tells others what he or she saw. That evening, the disciples, except for Judas, who had hanged himself, and Thomas, who was absent, were gathered together in a locked room because they were afraid the Jews would arrest them. Suddenly, Jesus stood among them and said, "Peace be unto you." Jesus showed them the scar on his body. He did not want them to be worried or afraid. He told them he was sending them out just as his Father had sent him out to be the witnesses to the entire world. They too were witnesses to the risen Savior. The disciples told Thomas they had seen Jesus, but he did not believe them. Thomas said he would not believe unless he touched Jesus' scars. 8 days later, Jesus appeared again to his disciples. Jesus spoke directly to Thomas and invited him to touch his scars. He wanted Thomas to know the truth and not have doubts. Thomas realized the man before him was truly the risen Savior. He was also an eyewitness. These were just some of the eyewitnesses to the risen Savior. The Bible says over 500 people saw Jesus after his resurrection. Jesus conquered death and he is alive. We can celebrate Jesus, the risen Savior, because we know the truth. Has someone ever made a promise to you and then broken it? Have you ever made a promise and then broken it? A promise is only as good as the person making the promise. Jesus' resurrection proved he was trustworthy. Jesus proved he was who he said he was, God's Son, when he came alive after being dead for 3 days. Jesus told his disciples he was going to die and be resurrected, but they didn't understand or believe him. When they saw the empty tomb and Jesus' resurrected body, they knew he could be trusted to do what he said he would, because Jesus did what he promised by coming back to life. We can trust the other promises he has given us in his word. The last verse of John chapter 20 tells us why John recorded these stories about Jesus. According to John chapter 20 verses 31, it says, "But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name." John wrote these things so we would believe Jesus is the Son of God and have new life in him. We can celebrate because those of us who believe in Jesus can know we will live forever in heaven with him. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2. Fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith. He endured the cross and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. This verse challenges us to look to Jesus. He was willing to die on the cross and be embarrassed in front of all his friends so we could know him and be saved. But where is Jesus now? This verse tells us he is seated in the place of honor beside God's throne. When Jesus came back alive, he lived on the earth for 40 days. Then he went back to heaven and is seated in the place of honor he had before the world began. Last week, we learned we have a choice whether to follow Jesus or not. God had a plan for Jesus to come to earth and die for our sin so we could have eternal life in heaven. The resurrection of Jesus is what separates Christianity from many other religions of the world. If Jesus had not conquered death, things would be very different. We would be forever separated from God and we would have no hope. We could not have any reason to celebrate today. Jesus told his disciples to go and tell everyone the good news, and as his disciples, we are to do the same. Your next step is to celebrate Jesus by telling two people the good news that he lives. For today's activity, you will need the activity sheet which is in the description box below, color material, scissors, yarn, and hole puncher. First, color the words, pictures, and then cut along the dotted line. Then use a single hole punch to make holes where indicated on each section. Then thread the yarn through the holes. Tie knots at the end. I encourage you to hang this somewhere around your house as a reminder that Jesus is alive. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this Sunday's lesson. Even though we cannot be together at this time, we can still grow our faith and worship our God. Thank you for joining me today. Make it a great week, and hope to see you next time. Bye-bye!